Where'd you put the change?
Right there.
Why are there pennies?
I gave you $2.
I told you I was getting a drink.
Use the money I gave you for quarters to buy a drink? Why would you do that?
I don't know.
Great. You want to be the one to tell Dakota we didn't get the truck washed because you wanted a Coke?
Calm down, hothead. There's a gas station across the street. Get change from there.
Great. You know what? I'm not paying for this. Give me a dollar.
Well, I don't have a dollar.
Of course you don't.
Hey, can you get me a Coke while you're there?
Very fun.
Shakespeare, he's in the alley with his pointed shoes and his...
Are we really gonna do this?
What other choice do we have?
She grew up in the Indiana town and a good looking mama who never was around, but she grew up tall.
Just driving through. Come on up here. Hey man, Dakota.
Danny.
Nice to meet you, Danny. Where are you from?
I'm from Indianapolis.
Danny hung around the commune for a while and soon became a part of the group. You're probably asking, what is the commune? Let's get you up to speed. This is the Redding Family Commune, home to a group of teenagers who either ran away from home or never had one in the first place. One of these members is Jack, who you see now. Danny and Jack became close friends pretty quickly. Dakota is the man in charge. A power-hungry alcoholic who couldn't get control over anything in his own life, so he tried to control others. He manipulated runaways by offering them a home and a family, something they didn't have, and they got it. But Dakota abused his power. He had them steal food and supplies, committing crimes at his order. But when law enforcement caught on, Dakota decided to load up on guns. That brings us to here, Danny Marks. To put it as simply as possible, Danny is an undercover cop. Sort of. He's a rookie investigator at the ATF. In an attempt to prove himself valuable, he decided to sneak away and investigate a group of kids buying guns in the middle of nowhere, Indiana. He planned on coming back after a week with evidence for a major gun bust and awaited all the glory to follow. But Danny fell in love with the commune. He befriended Jack, Mary, and Matt, and they became inseparable. All until the fateful day of July 22nd, when Jack needed some extra cash.
What
Dirty Harry.
You remember? Did you watch it?
What girl are you talking about? The one I know. Oh, I know what you're saying now.
She has blonde hair and blue eyes.
What was that place Dakota was talking about right down the road?
No, man, you gotta try Stoney's. It's right down the road. You take a left at the fire department. And, is that Macy?
Hold on. Let me go let her out.
Come over here and hold. I told you that I dressed you up in that very same dress just to see if he'd respond to you.
From the creators of Nine and a Half Quarters, Nine and a Quarter, an adventure of the century, rated R, opening April 27th at a theater near you.
The judge claimed Jack had killed Danny in cold blood, that he was a ruthless cop-killing monster, and so was everyone else at the commune. But that wasn't true. Monster. Anyone that knew Jack knew he wasn't even close to one. As for Dakota, I've never heard a better description.
Let him get away with this, right? We gotta get him back. Now here's how it's gonna go. You're gonna go down there to that sheriff's office. And you're not gonna just kill that sheriff. You're gonna kill every cop that's in that building. And you're not gonna come back until it's done. Now, I wanna make myself perfectly clear here. Every cop's gonna be dead. Well, you're not coming back.
Are we really gonna do this?
What other choice do we have?
We can run.
We have nowhere to go.
We have nowhere to stay either.
What about Dakota?
What about him? He doesn't care about us.
He's given us the only life we've known for the past year. Don't
you think? Now he's taking it from us. If we go through with this, we're going to jail. We're not getting away with this. There's no point in trying.
Well, I don't want to do it either, but I don't think we have much of a choice here.
You're right. We don't have a choice. If we do this, our life is over. All for nothing. Is that what we want? To end our lives so Dakota can get his revenge?
So, what do?
We run.
Thank you. laughing and shaking your head. Can you carry the torch that'll bring home the dead to the land of their fathers, whose lives you have led, to the station at the edge of the town?